constitution gets tested. The reason is, again, the great Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, if I recall one of his speeches, since I thought I have to produce it verbatim, so I just wrote it in my phone and brought it for you. Somebody asked him about constitution. He mentioned, a constitution which is unchanging and static, it does not matter how good it is, how perfect it is. Because most constitutions are past its use. It is in its old age already and gradually approaching its death. A constitution to be living must be growing, must be adaptable, must be flexible, must be changeable. As society changes, as conditions change, we amend it in the proper way. This is what Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, to quote him in its proper verbatim. So every new era sees a new challenge. The concept of radicalism was not there 1947. It is there for the past 20 years. It is there for the past 10 years. The so-called fundamentalism of any religious, be it Muslim, be it Christian, be it Hindu, the so-called fundamentalism is there for the past decade, very strong. Then we got an act called POTA, Prevention of Terrorism Act, very stringent act. Correct? Some of you must have read it. Very stringent act. The constitution makers felt, this is one act you bring in, the whole fundamentalism in India will come to a stop. The court said, no, this act is affecting the fundamental rights of citizen. So this is an act that is ultra vires of the constitution, meaning it is not in proper spirit of the constitution. Is it invalid? And again the POTA got changed and right now we have the UAP. Different act. So many a times you can crush many things with an iron hand. Many things. You bring a law which says that no women and men will walk outside after 10 PM. And the city police comes now. And there is a debate which says that so many crimes are happening in the city, in Bengaluru, in the night. So tomorrow morning I issue a standing order. I says no person would walk on the Bangalore street after 10 PM. After 1 month I clap myself telling, look how I control the law and order in the city. Everything has got a solution. No solution. If you go to Saudi Arabia or if you go to parts of Africa, that is how it is. You take something, you steal it, next day your arm is gone. Simple. You look at women in the wrong way, your eyes are gone. Simple. Yeah. Or you look at men in the wrong way, your eyes are gone. Let us be gentle. But in India, we have something called due process of law. Sometimes you feel very disturbed. What is this due process of law? I catch a criminal, he's there on the TV, the whole India has seen, and we have declared him guilty in the media trial that happens in the super prime time. And why is he not getting punished? In fact, we take 3 months, we take 6 months, there is a court and there is a court of appeal, and then finally there is the highest court of appeal called the Supreme Court. Even the great Ajmal Kasab, he came into India. 166 people he killed. Live television. All of us saw what he was doing. Maybe that inspired me to be a cop as well, that point of time, 2008, November 26. We have seen what he was doing. But still it took almost 3-4 years to sentence him to death, the final Supreme Court. The reason is, even the worst of the worst human being, in our Indian constitution, he gets something called due process of law. We all know you are guilty. But still I am giving you an opportunity to say, if you are not guilty, give me the circumstances and the evidence. That is why sometimes you feel the constitution has got so many loopholes. The rapes are happening in India, sir. Our women are suffering. Why can't you take those fellows out and overnight you kill them and throw them to the dogs? Fine. Some countries have gone this kind of a drastic approach. But India, unfortunately or fortunately, we live in a system where the constitution makers have decided the process should take precedence over speed. Maybe some countries felt speed should take precedence over process. Saudi Arabia, parts of the Islamic countries, parts of the African countries. We follow a different law. So that is why constitution might have loophole. You take the police commissioner, I clap myself and say that no men or women are walking, zero crime. The court will say, what a stupid police commissioner you are. You are violating the fundamental right of the Indian citizen. The right, fundamental right of an Indian citizen is free to move outside any point of time. Is free to travel to any part of India at any point of time. Is free to speak whatever he wants, Article 19. even the great Supreme Court, the famous St. Xavier's case, because in India, there is a lot of respect given to the minorities. Some religions, by its nature, by the number of population, we call it as a minority religion. Not in terms of thought process, very rich religion. In terms of their population, we call it minority, the same Christian religion. Some parts of the constitution, it gives them special preference over the majority. Special preference. Meaning, a Christian person can run an unaided educational institution. He can have his own laws, because the great St. Xavier's where we're talking is an institution that is established by the very process of the constitution. You have your own rules, own laws. You can decide how your admission process is. You can decide whom you want to admit. The constitution gave you that freedom. But somebody said, some government said, no, nahi chahiye. How can we give a minority institution some special preference in an education? So finally it went to Supreme Court, the great Nani Palkiwala, the finest eminent juror in the Indian history, he argued in Supreme Court. He said, nothing doing. It went before a full bench, the constitution bench, 11 judges they were sitting, to decide the St. Xavier's case, where the institutions like St. Xavier, St. Joseph should be protected so that the minority feels respected. Then the Supreme Court said the government is wrong. Minorities will have special freedom. It is there in the constitution. Because every time it balances, when people like me sitting in government, we overreach, the court will pull me down. You say, no, you are going too fast, boss. Calm down. That is why some people, when they sit outside, they see the TV, what is happening now. You see, our constitution is low. It has got so much loopholes. The criminals escape. Again, if you look at the systems, our criminal jurisprudence, they have another 10 more minutes, not a problem. Our criminal jurisprudence, it works on the simple fact. Even 100 criminals go scot-free, one innocent should not get punished. But if you look at the US system, US is a country of 36 crore population. America, if you compare with India, we are about 126 crore. But the number of people who are inside jail in America is 11 times more than the number of people who are in jail in India. Simple stats. For a kind information again. A country which has got 1/4 of Indian population has chose to put 11 times more people into jail than India. Because the US works on a different concept. That is why you see in National Geographic Channel, the crime issues and all, somebody after 37 years is declared as innocent. Somebody killed somebody, the DNA came now. Because they have a concept of plea bargain. Moment they catch a criminal, they say, if we conduct the trial, in the trial if I prove that you are guilty, you go to jail for 40 years. But if you accept to me now, I'll give you only 6 years. That is the concept of plea bargain. India said, we will not do plea bargain. Because plea bargain is a very faster way of doing it. But the plea bargain, the problem is, you will force a lot of citizens to accept a crime which they did not commit. US works on plea bargain system. We don't work on, we have a common law. We say, Ajmal Kasab, Mr. Ajmal Kasab. That is how he is addressed. The other fellow. Big trial happens. 16,000 page charge sheet is given in a court by the Mumbai police. Finally, we say, you are found guilty. Again, Ajmal Kasab will say, Nahi chahiye, sir. I want to go to High Court of Mumbai. Please go. And again, Ajmal Kasab will say, no, I want to go to Supreme Court of India. I am not satisfied. Again, we say, please go. Again, Ajmal Kasab will say, Supreme Court is also wrong. I want to go to the President and appeal before him. Again, we say, please go. That is the beauty of this nation. Don't worry. We have an inner and balance to balance those loops.